Fishing News is sponsored by these fine partners.
Black Sea Bass reopens in New Jersey and Delaware this Friday. 10 fish at 12 and a half inches here in New Jersey, 15 fish, 12 and a half inches in Delaware. I hope your boat is in, because at this point, we have no word on boats like this, the Dauntless, the Norma K, hopefully soon. I'm Jim Hutchinson with the New Jersey, Delaware Bay edition of the Fisherman Magazine. I posted a complete update earlier this week at thefisherman.com, a summary of the impacts and initiatives, what some of the groups like the RFA, Marine Trades Association, United Boatmen are trying to do to get some folks back into running these boats, and also doing something about our rental boats in New Jersey as well, especially here in New Jersey. The governor is aware of proposals by the industry, by the United Boatmen, by RFA, by the Marine Trades Association to get those folks operational. He said it, he acknowledged it in his daily briefing this week, earlier this week on Tuesday. His his answer to a reporter's question was, quote, "Nothing to report on recreational fishing, and if we have something, we will definitely let you know." Hopefully he definitely lets us know in the next couple of days. I'm still treating every day with a half full glass. Now on Wednesday, I was watching Governor Murphy's press briefing, and he ordered the curbside, where gave the opportunity for curbside pickup for those products for non-essential businesses in New Jersey. Of course, we've had that in our tackle shops in New Jersey. We had word on that weeks ago. So it's kind of nice to see the state of New Jersey picking up some advice and a good way of running business from the folks in our fishing industry, because we do have curbside delivery on those bait and tackle orders when you call by phone. Hopefully the state will acknowledge some of the other fishermen in other states. Virginia, for example. This Friday, Virginia charter boats are back up and running. So, yes, we have some good ideas. We just have to take it into account. Now, I hear Delaware from sources inside that they're close to pulling the trigger on the for-hire folks. But again, that unified approach with New York, Connecticut, and New Jersey, nothing is shaken out just yet. Now, I'm going to be following these briefings and manning the phones. So if something breaks, you'll find about it at thefisherman.com, find out about it. But also I would encourage you to go log in and like the Fisherman's Facebook page, because I'll share information there, and find me on Facebook as well. I'm trying to stay on top of this stuff as it breaks. Some of these things are coming out almost hourly. So stay tuned. We'll let you know of more information. But let's get on to the reports. The good news in the state of New Jersey in particular is a striped bass. Last Friday, I shared this photo on Facebook. Ed Plichta, he shared it with me. It's a 42-inch striped bass that he released off of Island Beach State Park. That was on the Troll, a number 4 white Maja spoon. Good sign of new waves of fish arriving out front. Also on Friday, Dennis Funaro checked in with Grumpy's in Seaside on the first really good fish of the season. It was checked in at Grumpy's, and also that we've heard of. It was a release. It was a 42-incher caught on clam. That was Dennis's personal best. So it's nice to see Island Beach State Park open. Some of these other beaches obviously opening up as well, but definitely some fish in along the wash. Over the weekend, we heard some good reports from the wash on LBI. In fact, Bayside Dave, we talked about him last week. He shared a picture of his friend Pat with a keeper caught mid-island on a bunker chunk. While just a little farther to the south, Andy at Riptide Bait and Tackle said Augie Conti, he stopped in for some Riptide bunker, and he texted him 15 minutes later, north end of Brigantine, which of course is open, sent this picture of a 43-inch bass that he caught and released. So it definitely looks good. I'd venture to guess that there will be more reports, good reports coming in between Absecon and perhaps Lavalette, which is open, in the coming days as bass are arriving. They're tight on bunker. Saw a video posted this week of a thresher shark in the wash, an LBI, so that's a good sign that those bunker are in tight, which means bass have got to be right there as well. And Don Voss let me know that he was working the night shift around Absecon middle of this week, had a nice fish, a 40-incher that he caught and released. Nice, healthy swimming fish out there for you to catch. Getting a few surf reports down on Delaware Bay as well. Folks at Higbee's reported that Mike Onichuk, he had a 37-inch keeper down on Fortescue Beach on Sunday. So finally, that action has taken place. Of course, that Delaware River up along the farther reaches north along the Delaware are working out. While across the other side at Broadkill Beach in Delaware, the folks at Lewis Harbor Marina let us know that John Davis was fishing for drum. Right there at Broadkill Beach, he was fishing with a sand crab, but lo and behold, he ended up with his 33-inch striped bass, rockfish. as my buddy Eric in Delaware would say. On to that drum front, because we're getting some really good reports on Delaware Bay, and now we're getting them on both the New Jersey and the Delaware side. Dennis Huber and his son Tommy, they trailer their boat up and down the coast in New Jersey looking for the best bite. Well, they ended up down on the full moon last Thursday on Delaware Bay. Tommy put the boots to the boomers, folks who dismiss black drum as not being good fighters. That's just silly. Some of these fish are absolutely incredible fighters. They look beautiful when they first come up on the surface. And I'll tell you what, food quality wise, 10 to 30 pound drum, those smaller, especially a smaller puppy drum, they just can't be beat. Absolutely fantastic. Of course, we still get good striped bass reports from up in North Jersey along the Rare Bay. Bobby Reed of Back Bay Plugs, he put a few of his own metal lips to the test while yakking a few good fish a couple of weeks back. Spoons, plugs, swim shads, live bunker, and chunks, all working up there on the Raritan Bay for some of those striped bass. Although John Sullivan let me know this week that his son Ryan got on them up to 40 pounds on the Raritan throwing topwaters and poppers. And again, you surfcasters, have those plugs all sorted and ready to go as these beaches start opening up more. I think we're going to find more opportunity and more fish waiting for us. Also, the one thing I mentioned last week is that there's another wave of fish. Still, those Chesapeake fish have got to come up and move up the coast. My friend Chris Dollar down in Maryland, he sent this shot of Dave Guerra, first mate Ryan Dean, and a 52-inch, 52-pound striper, spawned-out striper, I would add, that was caught on the Chesapeake on Sunday. It was taken on a 12-ounce white parachute tipped with a 9-inch shad. That was photo courtesy of Bay Hunter Charters. So that giant fish was in the Chesapeake just last week. Still has to come out, move up the coast. So hopefully we'll have another good 2 months worth of good striper action. And oh yeah, Governor Murphy, I believe those for hire guys are operating in Maryland as well. Don't forget our Coastal Kayak Clash. It's presented by the Fisherman Magazine. You kayakers, get out there and get in on some of the action right now, especially now the bluefish are running hot and heavy in New Jersey. They're running wild. We just need some inlet access, I think, to get some more reports. But I know some kayakers are hitting them. In fact, Dennis at the Hookhouse, he let us know that up the Toms River around Ocean Gate this week, some good-sized bluefish were biting. Many of those local rivers, back bays, are full of life right now, worth a look if the boat is wet. And with temperatures expected in the 80s on Friday, 70s on Saturday, it's a good idea, definitely good news. And again, it's a good time to jump on that kayak, check in with thefisherman.com, figure out how to enter the Coastal Kayak Clash. It's going on now. I want to hope somebody from New Jersey wins that tournament. Found a little snow in the Poconos last week. Hopefully that's not going to be an issue this weekend or anytime soon. Let's check in with my friend George, Pocono Outdoors guy.
Well, hey, thanks, Jim. You know, the weather continues to be the real big story. The coronavirus is here. We're working our way through that. Things here in Pennsylvania are starting to slowly open up, so we have to make sure that we're still staying responsible, wear our protective gear, and maintain our social distancing. But the weather here has been even harder for us fishermen. I mean, the return of winter last weekend, who knew? We even had snow here in the Poconos. But this weekend going forward, it looks like we're going to have some warmer temperatures, but we are still going to be fighting some of the high winds and some rain and clouds over the coming weekend. So fishing may still be a little tough, but the following weekend looks like we might break into those 80s and finally get into some more seasonal temperatures and let this water warm up and we can really get on some good fish. Now that doesn't mean guys aren't getting on fish. I got a full list of things this week. We had Mark Hines getting some northern pike in the Passaic River. He said they were really aggressive and they were hitting those Rapala shallow wrap, the jerk baits. Again, jerk baits are really producing this year and they got some great pike on them. Good friend Eric Goodstall is hitting some of these hidden lakes and ponds up here in the Poconos, way back in the woods. You got to hike into them, and he's getting into some great bass and also some great crappie, so he's being real successful there as well. Now I was also talking to Anthony Bottoms over at Sportmaster Bait and Tackle, and he's been hitting the Delaware. Now they're starting to see some really good stripers on the Delaware. He got this 22-incher down by the DOD, and it was released, of course, but he said they're hitting bloodworms really good, so that might be something you guys want to get out on the Delaware and get into some of those beautiful stripers. Also, Art Bagley was fishing over near Bushkill, and he got into some really nice smallmouth, and he's getting them on some black and purple spinner baits. Really great smallmouth bite. We want to definitely get on that as the season moves on. And And last, we have a Josh Fletcher out on the Delaware getting into some really great shad fishing. Josh said he got about 20 shad and one walleye fishing with his buddy this day. So that shad bite should be going on for quite some time with this cooler water. Maybe even get a really good extended season into June. So we'll see how it plays out, guys. Just be safe, be responsible, get out and fish, and we'll see you next time. From Pennsylvania, I'm George, your Pocono Outdoors guy.
Steigercraft boats, built by people who fish our waters. Serious Anglers choose Steigercraft for their 40 years of boat building experience right here in the Northeast and Mid-Atlantic. Visit Steigercraft.com for a dealer near you.
Now, in terms of good trout in New Jersey, I know a lot of folks always think Northwest Jersey and going up to Sussex County or going out to see George in the Poconos. But there are so many good stocked opportunities throughout New Jersey, even down into Delaware. Definitely worth a look, and I think a lot of people really picked up on trout fishing this year because of the COVID-19 crisis. Don't warn them, gulp corn them. That's the word from my friend Tom P. at Rack and Fin Radio. He stumbled into Scott Newhall, who was out and about looking for trout. 27-inch freshwater brute. Look at that sucker, 8 to 8.5 pounds. Tom says he's trying to convert Scott over to the Sweetwater side. Good luck with that. Seabass, I said, opens in New Jersey and Delaware on Friday. Next Friday, it's the official start of summer flounder or fluke in the state of New Jersey. Heard a lot of reports of bycatch here in the Manasquan up along the Shark River. We talked about Island Beach throughout Barnegat Bay down into Great Egg as well. So there's definitely fluke in the back bays, and I'm sure the guys in Cape May County are already tight-lipped about where they're going to be going. But those fluke are back there. Do understand there's a discussion about trying to extend the fluke season. Maybe extend some other seasons. Black sea bass, tog would be great. But this Thursday, New Jersey Marine Fisheries Council is meeting via webinar. That's gonna happen around 4 o'clock. They're actually letting you gotta register first. Then at 4 o'clock, they'll open it up so that everybody can figure out their technical issues. And then at 5 o'clock, they will hold that New Jersey Marine Fisheries Council meeting. And I'm anxious to find out if there's gonna be a discussion about trying to extend the season in any way. But anything that comes out of that on Thursday afternoon, I'll share it Friday into Monday, and you'll certainly find out about it in next week's video forecast as well. Compiling our weekly fishing reports for our weekly edition this week. Of course, it's an online edition, you subscribers. It's only available online. You gotta log in to check it out. New action, new access along areas in between. Big stripers up in North Jersey, the drum in South Jersey. It's on the headlines of this week's edition. So we're right on target with that. If you want some help as a subscriber, log it in. I left the video link down below in the notes, but you'll also see it here on the screen. You subscribers, don't forget, it's only digital access right now due to that COVID-19 crisis. Tragically, sadly, doing the reports on Sunday, found out some really sad news. My friend Dave Arbeitman from The Real Seat nearby in Briel passed away on Sunday. He was just 65. An innovator, tackle designer. He and his buddy Grant, many years ago, they were the first guys to do those tuna spreader bars. They were the first. I mean, Dave was an innovator, pushing the boundaries in offshore fishing, tile fishing. Also co-founder of the Save the Summer Flounder Fishery Fund. You have no idea, or perhaps you do, the amount of work Dave did behind the scenes with some other people to try to bring some more science to the table and also to fight for our access rights. I gotta send my prayers out to his family and especially the loyal staff over there at The Real Seat in Brielle. I'm really sorry about the loss, and fare thee well, Dave. I'm really gonna miss you, man. Another passing this week in the fishing community, longtime striped bass world record holder, Al McReynolds, whose 78.5-pound striped bass caught while fishing the Vermont Avenue Jetty in Atlantic City back in 1982, still stands as the benchmark for surfcasters. Found out from the Atlantic City Press that Al passed away at his home in Naples, Florida. Condolences to his family and friends, not just in Florida. He's got plenty of family and friends back here in New Jersey. That legendary photo, of course, of Al standing outside of Campbell's with that world record striped bass. That photo taken by my mentor, the great Pete Barrett. Like I said, as any news breaks today, tomorrow, next week, anytime, follow along with thefisherman.com. Go like us on Facebook as well, because we'll be posting information there. And also try to find me on Facebook, because I'm trying to keep people updated. Black sea bass opens Friday, and if we find anything about the Dauntless and the Norma K and the rest of the fleet sailing anytime soon, we'll let you know. Our fingers are crossed. Have a great weekend. We'll see you next week right here at thefisherman.com.